be here again.
Let's break it down. So much talk out there these days about Mike Conley, Marc Gasol. Is this inevitable, or what do you think?
I think that the core four is about to be no more.
okay. I think,
yeah. And ladies and gentlemen, he's also a poet.
I think that eventually they will be gone. Yeah. I don't think they will be gone anytime soon. Mm. And Larry and I were just talking about that, actually. But it's very, very sad. And as a fan and a season ticket holder, I'm very concerned because we don't – it's like, so now what?
Yeah. You should have been concerned before now.
Wait a minute, Larry, what do you mean by that?
No, you really should have been concerned before now. We got a serious issue with leadership with the Memphis Grizzlies.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're talking about the only player that Memphis has signed or drafted that has signed their second contract is Mike Conley. Mm-hmm. And then you allow Zach Randolph, Tony Allen, who are the patriarchs in a sense of the grind, of grit and grind. And then you come bring a guy in with Bickerstaff who really doesn't fit the community as much as you would like, or as a Fizdale. Fizdale was very outspoken. Mm-hmm. We got an issue with leadership.
So is that a leadership issue on the court, or is this in the front office?
Both.
We
said that in unison. Both, because upper management, we have a meticulously mute owner, an owner that doesn't talk.
And
that
this doesn't would be talk Robert to Robert Pera?
Yes, that doesn't talk to, and that doesn't work in Memphis. See, we know Memphis very, very well,
mm-hmm.
From a marketing perspective and all of that. And people in Memphis is a personality market, and if you have none, that's a problem. The team is what it is based on the character of the team and the personality of the team. And without the, and then we had an owner previously in Heisley that talked, that definitely engaged the community.
Mm-hmm,
you can't do this and succeed without in Memphis.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can be aloof and remote in other places, possibly.
Right, yeah. But not in this
not here. Well, I mean, February 7th, the deadline is coming up. Do you think that this has started some sort of awkward, you know, conversations between the two, or no?
It's as awkward as it could be.
Think so?
I mean, see him the other night. I mean,
I know, and it's like a little chest bump.
They were kissing each other.
Yeah. Make sure you love.
But you know what? It wasn't, I understand that.
Yeah.
That wasn't about the team.
Right.
Mm-hmm. That was between Marc and Mike.
Mm-hmm.
That was
so. The question is the Eminem boys gonna be here,
or when? Not?
Yeah,
or not.
Next year?
Are they gonna be here next year?
I don't think so.
Well, I don't think they'll be here, but I think they'll be here past the trade deadline.
Yeah.
I've heard so much speculation, especially in the past couple of weeks, about whether the team should just go ahead and tank or not. Are we to that point? I mean, to get
well, as I said last visit, you know, we really need to start building around Triple J. And Jaren Jackson Jr. Mm-hmm. We really need to start building there. With Marc and Mike, you probably going to keep them unless there's a contender out there that is looking to fill a piece, like Boston. You put Marc Gasol in the middle of Boston. You know, they got a great team. You put, you know, Mike Conley, where you need a point guard, a real serviceable point guard, like maybe a Minnesota or somewhere like that. And then you got injuries.
Mm-hmm.
So with it, by February 7th, of course, we'll know. But I'm anticipating they'll still be here, and then they'll get moved in the offseason.
But regardless, you still got to have a plan.
Mm-hmm.
You got to have a plan. I mean, we're on a train as fans, and my concern, I have some serious concerns. My concern is that we will just completely implode on the weight of our own foolishness in terms of the decisions
that
we are making.
Yeah.
And that's not a good thing, and it's really not a good thing for Memphis. But my prediction is that, and we've never won a national championship at anything, but my prediction is that Coach Penny Hardaway is going to change that dynamic.
Very interesting. Mm-hmm. We got to have you gentlemen back.
All
we can
right.
also catch you where again on SiriusXM?
Saturday mornings, 11 a.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Central, Channel 211.
Mm. Very good. Simone, as you can tell, they've gone big time.
I know.
Yeah. Congratulations, guys.
Always stars here.
That's it.